Hello and welcome to the Scottish Power Women's Premier League on BBC Sport Scotland. Today we're at Broadwood for Rangers against Partick Thistle. Two sides with strong starts meet at Broadwood Stadium, an entertaining match in store. Third against fourth early in the season. So let's have a look at the team news this afternoon. Rangers make three changes from the 1-1 draw against Glasgow City and give first starts of the season to Victoria Essen, who replaces Jenna Fife. Tessel Middag comes into the side too. She's been working her way back into the first team setup. She replaces Coulson, and Sarah Ewens is in to replace Chelsea Cornett. And the Rangers' talent just keeps on revolving. Keep your eyes on number 14, Mia McCauley, nominated for the August Goal of the Month, and already has three goals and four appearances for Rangers this season. Partick Thistle and Brian Graham also changed three for this afternoon. Megan Cunningham, the goalkeeper, and Jenna Ferguson, the centre-back, are both on loan from Rangers, so they can't play against their parent clubs. Also coming into the side is Imogen Longcake. She has two goals in her last two games, and she's a starter. She replaces Rob, who drops to the bench. Partick Thistle and that 5-0 win against Montrose last Sunday at Petershill, and they want to get closer to the sides that they met in the top six split last season. Their only defeat was against Glasgow City out of the four games previous. They won the other three. I'm sure if Brian Graham was offered 9 points from 12, he'd be very happy at that, but he'll be happy with the goal scoring efforts as well. Rangers will be disappointed that their 100% record came to an end with the draw against Glasgow City, and assistant Jay Bradford saying ahead of this one that winning becomes even more important today after that draw last Sunday. They're creating lots of chances. Well, she and head coach Joe Potter want to see more hit the back of the net. Delighted to say, joining me on commentary this afternoon at Broadwood, former Rangers midfielder Claire Gemmell. Claire, what do you make of the start that both teams have had in the SWPL so far?
I think they'll be extremely happy with the start they've had, particularly Partick Thistle, as you said, only failing to beat Glasgow City in their first four opening games. So today I'm expecting a good game, to be honest. I don't think that Rangers should underestimate Partick Thistle. I think they've been trying to get at teams, and I expect to see that today, and we see Rangers going back to a back three by the looks of it. So I think there'll be space there for Partick Thistle to exploit.
And Partick Thistle have scored 12 goals in the league so far, so they sit in fourth when it comes to the goals scored. And Rangers are still looking for their first clean sheet of the season. Is that something that's maybe in Joe Potter's mind with the replacement of Victoria Essen coming in place of Jenna Fife? Or is it just more of what we saw last season under Malky Thompson, where there's two strong goalkeepers in the squad, so it's just about the rotation?
I think it really will just be down to rotation, to be honest. I don't think it'll be anything that Jenna Fife has done. But it gives Victoria and Essen an opportunity to try and claim a shot. But I think rotation is important. You see how long the season is, the amount of games that they've got. So I think it's more, that's nothing more than that. So Essen's here to try and take a chance.
Thistle did fail to score against Rangers last season. In the four meetings, they conceded 19 goals. But they come to Broadwood to take on Rangers after a reset from the defeat to Glasgow City and a big win against Montrose. As the sides come out of the tunnel, Rangers led by Nicola Docherty, club captain Demi Faulkner leading out Partick Thistle. There's the Rangers coaching staff, Joe Potter, ready for this one. Said she wants her players to be a little bit braver and keep the ball for longer periods against Glasgow City in the clash previously. Brian Graham will be hoping that his side can get back to their usual against Glasgow City in that 3-0 defeat earlier in the season. There was maybe a little bit of a sign of the changes that have been made to the squad through the summer. And just searching to keep that consistency, building that with all the changes that have been made. Rangers looking for similar as both teams go through the last warm-up. The referee in the middle this afternoon is Jamie Wilkie, in charge of this one. Two games have already been played in the SWPL fixture card this weekend. Last night, Glasgow City 2-0 winners against Hearts, so they sit at the top of the table as it stands. Aberdeen with a 3-0 victory away to Spartans in the 1 p.m. kickoff. A number of late afternoon starts today in the top flight. Some final words from Demi Falconer. This season as a Partick Thistle player. Kirsty McLean, Mia McCauley alongside Rio Hardy. A mixture of the exciting youth and new signings. We said, Claire, that Jay Bradford was talking about how winning becomes even more important after dropping points against Glasgow City. Does that mean you expect to see a really fast start from Rangers?
I expect to see a fast start, but I think Joe Potter and our coaching staff would be expecting that most weeks from a Rangers point of view. But I think it's important that they do start quickly, because I think if they allow Partick Thistle to come into the game, they're going to cause them a lot of problems, and I do think we're going to see that today.
Off we go. Rangers throw. Rachel McLaughlin over to take. Catherine Hill immediately launches that to the other side. An applause from Joe Potter in the background. You can already see that wide space at the back for Rangers, looking to use with McCleary there on the right side. Forward now. Henderson, the Thistle number 9, back to do the pressing from the front line. Strong season for Rachel McLaughlin last year, 42 appearances, 7 goals in all competitions. Such a threat when it comes to the goal scoring. It's so important at the back too. Rio Hardy spotting McCauley in space over there. Just wasn't able to find her feet.
You see already the problems the larger pitch is causing Partick Thistle. Rangers are looking for that early switch, knowing that if they can get it out there, that they're really going to cause Thistle issues.
Henderson might be in here. Longcake's coming up into the area on the left side. Good hold up play. Dangerous looking ball across. McLaughlin will clear. Sarah Ewens will hold. And a comfortable run, still has space ahead of her. Options left and right. Goes for the shot, drags that one well wide. Just finding her striking boots at the moment, Sarah Ewens, signed in the summer from London City Lionesses.
It's a really good driving run forward from her here, but I think it's the wrong decision she makes. I think Mia McCauley's in a bit of space and just to the left of her, she can slip her in, but she'll maybe see it, why not shoot? She has a striker after all.
Outstanding goal scoring record in the SWPL. That's Celtic before the move down south. The Easton's kick out will go all the way out. The unknown Glasgow City goalkeeper, Scotland under 15, under 17 international, only 17 year old, but a lot of potential when you speak to people around the Scottish women's football circuit. Hardy helps it on. Cleary lets it bounce. Slater looking to get away. Tessa Midach also in for her first start of the season.
What I have been impressed with over the first 4 games for Rangers is the relationship that Hardy and Howitt have seemed to develop. They link up really well and the goals that they've managed to score from that, but I think the only thing for Kirsty Howe is she's maybe just not getting the score sheet enough.
The referee bringing the play back. You could see just from that previous passage of play, Thistle trying to be alert and aware of those cross-field passes for the wide defenders to step up and intercept. Watson charged down by McCauley. And Graham watches on as this side look to work their way up the pitch. Anderson the target. Gets her way around Catherine Hill, and the last ditch sliding challenge is inch perfect, but Thistle still have a chance. The deflection takes it behind for the first corner of the afternoon, and it goes the way of the visitors.
It's great play by Henderson, isn't it? Such good hold-up play. She gets the better of Catherine Hill and Nicola Docherty, and she's got her side a corner, and this is where they're a massive threat.
Yeah, the opportunity for Thistle to work the set piece. Henderson towards the back. And with that cluster, Lawton there. The referee just has a bit of a conversation at the back post between Imogen Longcake and Sarah Ewins. Longcake heads straight for Victoria Essen and the Rangers' goal. It's towards Henderson. Lawton's there too. Hill will swipe clear. Rebecca McGowan got the touch, but McCauley takes over. McLaughlin away from Longcake. Here's captain Nicola Docherty. Slid through for Hillett. Now Ewins. It's aggressive play from Thistle as Cody Hayes just looking for Henderson, and it just didn't click between the two.
You see Henderson's wanting it earlier, she's pointing, she's saying, give me the ball, and she just can't get her head up quick enough. But see if they can just get that pass in early enough, she was away.
Only 5.5 minutes played, but Brian Graham will be very happy to see that energy from his side. Hill, pointing, but continues. Docherty steps up. Something for Howitt to chase. Easton will come all the way out in control of that situation. Slater finds Longcake. Poked away by McLaughlin. That little pause opened up the space. That pass isn't clean. Lawton just trying to thread it through for Hay. Wasn't successful. Hardy. Patrick Thistle take over. Longcake on the move. Henderson looks onside, but the flag is now raised. There's a question. I think a lot of eyes went towards Nicola Docherty in the far side. The assistant paused for a second, and the flag went up to deny Cara Henderson.
At first look at it, I thought she'd just ran off and then had come back onside actually, but I'd need to see the replay again, but I think it was really tight. But Rangers are holding such a high line even when Partick Thistle are coming into their half, so the space is unbelievable in behind them if they can find the right pass.
It'll make for some excitement this afternoon, I'm sure. That line can never rest, and Cara Henderson's around in attack. Rachel McLaughlin has time. McCauley. McLean asks. Flicks the ball all between her feet. Spotted the run of Hardy. Didn't get there. Ewins tries to collect. Scrappy. Thistle managed to get it away. I think Amy Bullock took a bit of a sore one there in the aftermath. She's trying to walk it off. Here she is, challenging Ewins, who asks for the free kick. The referee happy to play the advantage. Mia McCauley on the charge. Stopped by Lawton. Tara Henderson ends up in the Rangers technical area. Are they allowed to roll on?
I think that probably is a foul. I do see that you can use your shoulders, but it looks too forceful to me. I think that's a foul.
Whistle defend it. Slater just can't quite pick out long cake. There's a replay of the earlier incident. Helen Henderson going hip to hip. Henderson claiming there, as do her teammates, but the referee didn't see anything illegal. She's still holding her face, Cara Henderson. Sarah Ewins picks up possession. Rachel McLaughlin's just checking that she's okay. I think Cara Henderson's instruction is, well, it's a head knock, referee, so prize play still going on. And then we'll come over to check that she's okay.
I actually wonder if her mouth's bleeding. She seems to be touching her lip quite a lot, as if she's maybe had a sore one to the face.
You could see immediately she knew there was concern, and Rachel McLaughlin too was aware of that and just wanted to make sure Cara Henderson was okay to continue.
That's completely accidental. It's not intentional in any way, but it will be a sore one to the face.
Partick Thistle's Young Player of the Year last season in her first year. What a signing she's been for the Jags. August SWPL Player of the Month nominee too. Brian Graham made the adjustment last season, looking to turn her into a number 9, a role that he knows so much about. Ross Stormont there out with some tactical advice possibly too. Used to be within the Rangers Academy here. Now the assistant at Thistle. Henderson will go off after some treatment, ready to enter again. Rangers get the ball rolling. In that deep position, neat touch, picks up the pace. Hardy exchanges with Howitt. Ewins asked for it, but it didn't get there. It's loose from McLean. It's been a fairly competitive start, Clare. You could hear that from the crowd on that far side too. Both coaches have been right on the edge of the touchline. This one fiercely battled already.
It has been, but I actually think Brian Graham will be happier, the two managers. I think Thistle have started really, really well. And although Rangers probably have had a bit more of the ball, they're not really doing too much with it at all. I would say Thistle are picking it up in more dangerous areas.
Sinclair, the touch for Henderson, looking to feed long cake. Miscommunication in the Rangers midfield. Bullock, lovely pass out wide. Lawton stepping up, dangerous ball over, seen all the way by Victoria Essen, New Zealand international. She looks the set, Jodie McCleary flying. So back in positions though. McLean using the space. Colley. McLean to McLaughlin. Middack spins, headed through, taken away by Taylor. Easton will have to come and step onto that one, and launches that upfield.
They have been very organised in that sense, where Rangers are trying to thread passes in between the lines, and they're covering really well, and they're not allowing the space in there for them to link up and get the third man run through.
Lachlan dipping that one for McCleary. Touch to set. Sarah Ewan supporting. McLaughlin to Rangers, having to manoeuvre to find space in that thistle shape. Docherty thought about the strike, lays off McCauley. Speedy move and whips one over, sails over the crossbar. Thistle won't want to let her onto that foot too much from that side. You could see she had one thing in mind when she managed to make her way into the edge of the area.
It's very good play by her, really positive. It's something she loves to do, is come in off the left side onto her right foot and shoot. And if they give her the space, she's going to do it all day long, and one of them will end up in the net if they don't get out to close her down.
One of the positives of younger players is sometimes there's no fear there and they just want to attack and they're willing to try and bring those magic moments.
It's great to see, and why shouldn't they play with confidence? Joe Potter's seen the youth in this squad and given them the chance, so take it.
Evans runs out of room. This will throw. Speaking of youth, Lucy Inman of Rangers joined Queen's Park on loan this week. McLaughlin shaking her hand after taking a knock in that play. One to keep your eyes on between her and Henderson this afternoon. Partick Thistle just looked to push Rangers back. Tighten that space in the corner. Essen spots McCleary. It's well worked by McCleary. McLaughlin though. Bullock's there. There's just no way for McLaughlin to move forward and has to go back, so it's good play from the away side.
I actually think that should have happened earlier. It took for Amy Bullock to then come up and really aggressively press. They had Rangers in that back corner with Essen and McLaughlin, and they've kind of laboured to the press. I think if they can get their head down there, they can win the ball back.
How it down, Rangers free kick. And there's a bit of a conversation going on with the referee. He wants to have a word with Cody Haight. And McLaughlin unsure of why that's happening, but here's the play. She's coming in late there.
She's completely missed the ball there, hasn't she, and took Kirsty Howitt's legs.
Docherty and McCauley exchange. Space opened on the opposite side. Rachel McLaughlin too high for McCleary. You see what Rangers are trying to do though, use the space that opens on the opposite side and just move the ball quickly to take advantage of that. Long cake. Moses out to McLaughlin.
I think that's going to be a really interesting battle between those two today.
Ewins could be through. The flag is raised by the assistant. Feels like there's so many little individual battles as well as the team battle on the pitch already in the first quarter of the game.
It does, but that's exactly what you want watching a game of football, for those battles to be there. And there I actually think maybe it would benefit Rangers to go a little bit more direct. Rachel Ewins bending a run and getting in behind.
Docherty wins the header. Flag raised against Partick Thistle this time. Medak with a layoff. Long kick. Shields the ball well. Bullock too far ahead of Henderson. McLaughlin spots the run of Hardy. She's there first, Rio Hardy. McCleary gives her the ball back, driven low. Taylor misjudges the bounce. Easton commanding the shout of keepers. and collect safely. We know what it means. To throw. Hardy. Heavy touch. Anderson all alone giving chase. And Rangers players using the ball.
Every time Rachel McLaughlin's getting on the ball, she's looking up for options, and she's really only got Jodie McCleary or the ball in behind. There's not enough, probably, from the midfielders for her, and that's why they're really struggling to get out the other side, because, and that is where the space is. But I think it's credit to Patrick Thistle, just the way they're playing.
McLean away of the space for McCauley. Ewan's ahead. Rolls it back out for Mia McCauley. Kirsty McLean stands strong. Hewitt looking to get there. First time strike. And it nestles into the net. Eva Easden looked uncomfortable as she dived. But the ball through was perfect for Kirsty Hewitt to run onto. Unleashed the strike. It's an unfortunate year last Sunday towards the end of the City draw. But she's on the score sheet for the season, and Rangers take an early lead.
It's a great pass by McLean and Kirsty Hewitt. And Kirsty Hewitt takes a shot on early, which I don't know if Easton's not expecting it, but she seems to kind of lose her footing almost, and it floats in under her. I think she'll be disappointed that she's lost that goal, particularly from that angle. But Kirsty Hewitt won't be caring, and hopefully Rangers will see themselves settle down after this, because I don't think they've been that great up until now.
She scored in the 3-0 win here in May against Partick Thistle. That's now three goals in her last three games against Brian Graham's side. We've seen some fantastic strikes from Hewitt down the seasons. But that one, he's been unable to get to. But the aim was perfect for Hewitt to just tuck the ball into the back of the net. And after the difficult start, Thistle will look to keep going. There's Lawton up towards Henderson. Essen takes that one.
It's a good response though from Partick Thistle. They've not let their heads go down. I think it's important that they do that, that they keep themselves in the game and they stick to their game plan, because up until now it certainly has been working for them.
McLaughlin feeding the ball in behind. Something Claire mentioned earlier. One of the options used by Rachel McLaughlin is starting to cause a bit of trouble. Thistle just look to push that back line higher up the pitch. Here's McLaughlin again. Fifth appearance of the season. Docherty, her fifth straight start. Klein had to be quick with that one. How about the goal scorer? Kirsty McLean runs on. Four options ahead. Collie's the choice. She'll race Lawton into that corner. The Rangers 14 who gets there first, but she can't keep the ball in play.
the pace she shows there is unreal, isn't it? Into that corner, you think that ball's away, particularly with the wind, and she catches it preventing the bike kick, and it's out for a throw-in where they can at least contain Patrick Thistle in their own half.
Nicola Docherty, the captain, was speaking about her recently, and the way she described Mia McCauley's pace was different level.
I would agree with that, just watching her here, you know, how quick she is, and just watching her in the games for this season, I think she's been really key to them, and I would say now it's her jersey to lose.
She's buzzing to start against City, never mind score a goal too. Great composure as she was through on goal. That draw last Sunday. Now looking for Henderson. Apologises for the pass after the ball's away, but Cara Henderson's chasing, you never know what might happen. Lawton has everything to get to it.
You can see what Partick Thistle are trying to do there, and I do think the right idea is to try and get in a 1v1 with Catherine Hill, but at the moment when they're playing the ball to her, her supporting players are too far off her. So if she is winning it in a wider area, there's nowhere for it to go.
This is Sinclair. But she would move away with the ball. The referee blows for the free kick against Rebecca McGowan.
I'm not really sure what that was given for. I don't think that was a foul. I didn't see too much in it, but the referee obviously thinks that there was enough in that.
McCleary. Moon starts to run through the middle. McCleary can't continue. There's Rosie Slater's there. Former Rangers player. How about the goal scorer? McLaughlin. Docherty. Middags made the run. It drops to Hardy. Now Kirsty Howitt. Collected by Easden. She'll feel happy about that one.
I think Kirsty Howitt's obviously gained a little bit of confidence from that goal, and that's why obviously she thinks she can take on the shot on her weaker foot. And absolutely, why not shoot? But I think Easden will be glad to just collect the ball into her hands and get a wee bit of confidence for herself.
Lawton stands strong. Thistle Madag. Jodie McCleary. McLaughlin moving. Longcake stands in her way. Attention this last couple of minutes, Partick Thistle just seeming to drop further and further back into their own penalty area.
Yeah, Rangers have upped the pressure a little bit, haven't they, and they've pushed further and further back, but they need to watch that they don't remain there and try and push back up the pitch.
And Thistle will push. He'll take the throw. Scotland international Nicola Docherty, 45 caps now, 2 goals in an international account. Hill. Rangers look for control possession out of the back line. Hardy, Joe Potter's second Rangers summer signing. Hardy again. McLaughlin finds McCleary. Pass evades Slater. Bullock gets toes to stop Hardy. Rosie Slater now on the ball. Imogen Longcake. Starting to look a bit tough out there on that left wing. Whenever she picks up possession, Rangers handed it back.
It's hard for her though, she's out there and she's isolated. You need to get the likes of Sinclair in the midfielders that Bullock closer to her, so she's got options underneath her if she's got her back to Rangers' goal. But it's the right idea from them, but I don't think they're quite getting it right at the minute.
Partick Thistle were a tough test in the top flight for any side. The top six last season, results were tight. Only lost 2-0 to Celtic away, 1-1 away to Hearts, lost 3-0 to Rangers, 2-1 away to Glasgow City. And that was at a familiar setting at Peter's Hill. Taylor. Searches for Slater. No Rangers press, so any side happy to keep a hold of possession. Slater's an option at the bottom of your screen. It's in for Sinclair. Close control. Very well done from Lucy Sinclair. Slater's now pushing. Thistle getting bodies forward. Can Slater cross? McLaughlin stands in place. But that will encourage the visitors.
It definitely will. It's really good feet from Sinclair to get away there and get turned and find Slater on the left-hand side.
Good communication from Rangers towards Kirsty McLean. The players were coming back while she was in possession. Doherty. Hawkins ball out to McCleary again. Herrick wasn't ready for the run.
I actually wouldn't be surprised if we've seen McCleary and McCauley switch at one point. I don't think that they're getting enough joy down the wide areas that Joe Potter would be expecting in this game, so I really wouldn't be surprised if we've seen them switch.
Are you surprised that Rangers haven't upped it a bit more since taking the lead through Kirsty Howitt's goal?
Yeah, they seem to get a little bit of momentum off the back of the goal, but it's died a death a wee bit again, hasn't it? Partick Thistle will welcome that right enough, and I think they should use these moments to their advantage. I just think they lack a little bit of movement, particularly when the players have got it at the back. You maybe are looking for Henderson and Sinclair to switch positions, pull Rangers apart a little bit, because right now it's very rigid.
This field to have slowed down from that opening quarter. It was so passionately competitive. Long kick. McLaughlin stabs the ball away. She claimed the touch off the Partick Thistle player. That's the away side who have the throw-in. She's towards Sinclair. McLean pokes the ball away. A bit short for Slater, but she makes use of it. Sinclair. McCleary can't prevent the ball going across the line for the corner. And it'll be Partick Thistle's second of the afternoon.
Although the throw-in's not came to anything, they've managed to win the corner, which I think they'll be playing for. Will be set pieces, like some free kicks and corners. As I said right at the start, they are very dangerous from them.
That's the only side of the corner opportunities in this first half so far. It's a collection around Victoria Essen and the Yellow Rangers goalkeeper kit. Sent over by Bullocks on top of the goalkeeper, but she's strong, Victoria Essen, and she looks to start the Rangers counter. Kirsty McLean will pick up, McCauley's wide, ball's fed through. And the flag is raised on this near side. Celtic Thistle have the free kick. I have to say, well defended, because we spoke about Mia McCauley's pace, so that will be a dangerous ball played into that channel through it this afternoon.
It's really dangerous, and it's obviously a tactic that Rangers are using. That's the second time that they've had a corner, as you said, and it's the second time that if Essence collected the ball, she's threw it out really quickly, trying to start an attack. So that's obviously something they're trying to exploit, particularly Mia McCauley with her pace.
How about turning? Cleary well spotted on this right side. Walking, offering the support. McLaughlin. Hill, who was called up to the Scotland squad last season. Over to Docherty. Hardy, touch creates space. Brought down by McCleary. Loughlin looking to get in behind. Clipped up, Easton pushes it away. And Hardy strikes. And it's high and wide. That was an important touch from Ava Easton. Started in the 3-0 win against Hamilton in last month. A competitive debut. Really strong fingertips here, because that looked a dangerous cross from McLaughlin. She's at full stretch and Hardy can't finish.
It's great play, driving into the box, really, really positive by McLaughlin. Great clipped cross in towards the back post, and as you said, Easton does so well to get a hand on it, and then it falls to Hardy, who some control with her heel, and then you expect her to hit the net with it, but fires it over.
McCleary. Can she catch Hardik Thistle out? Now it's on her left. She takes. Charged down. Midak. Kirsty McLean. Thistle have a player hurt. McLaughlin. Aims for the byline. The cross again. And header! Over the bar. It was that move once more. And Jodie McCleary takes her frustration out on the goalpost.
It just looks so dangerous every time McLaughlin goes forward. That's probably where they're creating their best chances, actually, rather than from their two wingers. It's a great cross in. I actually think McCleary's coming down the way when she meets it, and that's why she can't get the connection on it. And it goes over the bar. I think she'll be so frustrated with herself. We'll be seeing that when she kicks the post. But it probably really should have been a goal. It should be 2-0.
It's almost too close to the goal line that it's hard to just try and get your head over the top of the ball and direct it down the way.
It is a difficult one, because I do think she's on her way down. I think she jumps too early and she's on her way down when the ball comes to meet her head. But I think she'll be fuming at herself that it's not went into the back of the net. It's a great run in from the wide area into the back post, as Rachel McLaughlin's taking her area. So she'll be delighted that she's got herself into the position. But yes, she'll be disappointed that she's not actually taking the chance.
Jodie McCleary scored a double in the 6-1 win over Spartans to start the season. Looking to add to those two goals this season. Will she get a better chance than that this afternoon? Slater beats her to the ball there. Hill heads away. Sinclair sends it back. Flag raised for offside. Kirsty McLean. Scoping out McCleary, but Slater in the way. Long kick takes. Ewan's got a foot to the ball. That only leads to Cody Hay. Just trying to whip it around for Sinclair, but that's got too much pace on it. Almost looked like she was in two minds whether to aim for Sinclair or Henderson, who was running in towards the penalty spot.
Yeah, I think Brian Graham will be annoyed. Probably they've given the ball away in that situation. They've picked it up in a good area. She'd have flared over Laffiner. Maybe would have been the better choice, just to try and keep the ball and allow her teammates to get up into the box. It's a really, really difficult cross from that position, and it would have had to have been pinpoint.
Maybe he again. for Taylor. Cam defending, spinning on the ball. Couldn't use it. Midak. Moons had to look behind. She's wide, so tries to cross. She'll have a second go. Swiped away by Faulkner and immediately asks her line to push up. McLaughlin, long range. Easden can see that one harmlessly wide.
It's a really good run by Younes into the box, and it doesn't, it breaks to McLaughlin at the edge of the box. We have seen her score them before, but again, probably similar to the other situation when he had the ball, it's probably the wrong decision. When you've got so many players into the box, can you pick somebody out who's closer to the goal and in a better position?
That one away. Henderson will look to come into the game. McLaughlin aims to prevent that. Lucy Sinclair. The right idea for Cara Henderson. A little too much on it from Lucy Sinclair.
You can hear Brian Graham shouting on there to Sinclair about taking care of the ball. It's really, really good position that she's picked the ball up in. You can see what she's trying to do, just doesn't get the execution right.
Sinclair was key for Hamilton Accies in their top flight stay over the last couple of seasons, formerly of Glasgow City. She'll be a really important signing for Partick Thistle this season. A number of lows, as Brian Graham said, he feels that squad's the strongest it's been in depth since he's been in charge. Rangers have the free kick. Five minutes to play. Howitt filled. Cathy Hill in a hurry. Rangers want a larger advantage going into the half-time break. McLean drops the shoulders. Cleary gives to McLaughlin. Long kick blocks. Cleary. McLean. Walking creates space for herself. And now Jodie McCleary. She's four in the penalty area. She can't make her mind up. And Cara Henderson will be one on one with Nicola Docherty. The support arriving to her right. And Hill connects the challenge, brings Henderson down. And a yellow card shown to Hill. And one of those clear game aware. When you see the player as a defender going away from you, the next thing on your mind is make the challenge and try and halt the danger.
That's what you would call a professional foul. She's obviously felt as if she's had to make the challenge. They were left really vulnerable at the back, Nicola Docherty there on her own, and Patrick Thistle players bursting to try and get forward. So she's obviously felt she's had to make the challenge there, because I think if they'd get the pass away, then it would have been trouble for them.
There was lots of space there, and that's why Cara Henderson turned to have a look at the referee, feeling that challenge had one purpose, and that was just to bring her down. But Thistle have the opportunity from the free kick. Six away. Bullock clips it over. It drops for Haight. Midak gets it away. Slater. A deep run from Lawton, who looked onside. Rangers stood and watched. Nelson collects.
I think they're going to be really disappointed with that. That's a very, very good area to have a free kick from, and it's not even beating the first man.
Hill goes down. Play continues. Slater. Long kick. McLaughlin slides and hooks away. Faulkner over. McLaughlin's taking a sore one there. that competitive contest on show again. He said that Thistle will be frustrated. Clare, just a couple of minutes to go until half-time. It's still there for Partick Thistle to get back into this game. And that'll be the one thing that Joe Potter probably will be mentioning if the score stays the same going in at half-time.
It will be. It's 1-0, so absolutely they're still in the game, and I think they will know that. So obviously you can see that they're still trying to keep it as tight as possible. They're not wanting to commit too much forward, but they know that they will get chances, particularly from set pieces. Hence why I think Brian Graham and the team will be frustrated by that last free kick, because this is the opportunities that need to take and at least put pressure onto the Rangers goalkeeper.
McCauley skips away. Taylor swipes. McLean stabs it onto Docherty. Hill. Hardy. Referee blows for the free kick. Thistle supporters frustrated. Well, Rangers stretch their lead. 50 seconds before we move into the added on time. Faisal Medak, Netherlands international, has been working her way back into the first team setup after missing opening two league games. And as a sub in the last two, on her first start of the season. There she is again, heading away, cushioned for McLean. Walking over. Don't think Slater was the intention. It still worked out. Here's Lindsay Taylor. Emma Lawton. Cody Hay tries to put fire in those feet. Doherty's camp. McCauley. Lawton races up. He uses experience to run into the space rather than forcing anything. Lovely pass from McLean for McCauley. She asks for some help. In no hurry. Referee has a quick look at the watch and blows for the half-time whistle in what has been an intense and competitive 45 minutes between Rangers and Partick Thistle. But it's Rangers who have the one goal lead thanks to Kirsty Howitt and Kirsty McLean wheeling away from two Thistle players. The through ball for Howitt, who had a look up and the early strike towards goal. Ava Easden looked like she just couldn't sort out her feet, and she could only watch as the ball nestled into the bottom right corner of the net. And that opened Kirsty Howitt's account for the SWPL season, and that means at half-time at Broadwood, it's Rangers 1, Partick Thistle 0.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Broadwood. Half time, the score is Rangers 1, Partick Thistle 0. Kirsty Howitt with the opening goal, and opening her Rangers scoring account for this SWPL season. There is the goal scorer as Rangers go through a warm up before the start of the second half. Partick Thistle do so similarly on the left side of the pitch. Will be encouragement from their head coach Brian Graham at the half-time team talk for the way they started this game and the score remaining close. Meanwhile, for the Rangers head coach Joe Potter, she'll be happy to be in front, but she did mention about the second half against Glasgow City. She wanted her players to be a little bit braver, and I have a feeling that may have been a similar conversation at the interval. She'll want the possession that Rangers have had in the first half to count a bit further. But as it stands, it is only the 1-0. Partick Thistle still in this one as the referee Jamie Wilkie blows the whistle for the start of the second period. That Rangers possession in the first half at 65% as Henderson closes down Essen. She'll be hoping to get a bit more involved at the start of the second half after chasing everything at the end of the first half, but that kind of advanced forward cause of loose balls being the best on offer. Delighted to say that Claire Gemmell joins me today on commentary at Broadwood. Claire, you see Cara Henderson just trying to lead by example at the front here for Partick Thistle. What do you think Joe Potter will have asked of her players?
I think it's probably just what you said, Stuart, about retaining the ball a bit better. She has spoke about that in previous interviews, saying how that she wants them to possess the football for longer periods of time. I do think the first half they were turning the ball over probably a little too easily, so she'll be wanting them to retain the ball a bit better and hopefully then create better chances into the final third. Although I do think Partick Thistle have been doing really well defensively to limit Rangers' chances, but they're probably, from a Brian Graham's point of view, they're not creating enough up top.
Long kick will lift this one over. Couldn't keep it in play. Former Newcastle United Middlesbrough player joined through last season. Now back for her first full campaign. Brian Graham, a big fan of the energy she brings to the team. A challenge there on Howitt. Lindsay Taylor makes her move away. There's concern being shown by Mia McCauley, and she will require some treatment, and not what Rangers want to see at the start of the second half.
That's a clear foul, isn't it? She's looking at the player, she's looking at the back of Kirsty, how it goes into her. She's not interested in the ball at that point. I think it's far too forceful, and she's probably lucky she's not been booked, actually.
Heavy collision into the back. Kirsty Howitt has something to say afterwards. Rangers will look to build. Out with the flick on there, but another collision into the back, and she looks uncomfortable, the Rangers goal scorer. It's Easton will launch the ball upfield, just trying to get back into position in the centre circle now there, Kirsty Howitt, but she's holding her head. Henderson releases Emma Lawton, charging through, but gets the touch wrong. She applies pressure to Doherty. Essen will take, but the referee will blow for the free kick. And it has started in a similar fashion to the first half, Claire. That energy coming back amongst the players.
It has done. Obviously the 15 minute break has given Partick Thistle a bit of time to rest in the cover and come out. They've come out, they've started well. Really good positive play down the wide area. She just trips over the ball and then loses it from her foot and fouls Nicola Doherty. But it's good play from them. And I think Essen actually has been pretty casual at the back at times, hence why Henderson got the first opportunity and pressing her down, but similar just a minute ago as well, where she's taking quite a long time to actually kick the ball forward.
Cody Haight. Sister Brogan not in the Rangers squad this afternoon. Tony McCleary shows strength to prevent Emma Lawton. Jodie McCleary at 6 Scotland under 19 caps, 2 goals. And against Albania back in April. Another exciting youngster there, Amia McCauley, but the whistle was blown. Partick Thistle have the throw. Brian Graham is asking his players to keep the momentum going at the moment. They go looking for an equaliser. Throw only to Rachel McLaughlin though, and she'll release as far away upfield as she can. Partick Thistle failed to score against Rangers last season. Another ball for Henderson to chase. The last to deal with it. The last touch off the Thistle forward. She encourages her teammates forward to press Rangers into the corner. How it takes. Ewens moves forward. Taylor stabs. Long kick goes down. Referee looks and blows for the free kick. And we spoke about encouragement being the main word for Thistle at the start of the second half. There's plenty of energy there, plenty of positivity in this opening 6 minutes.
There has been the pressing Rangers really high, trying to pin them back, which is what they've done at the start of the first half. And again, they found themselves with a free kick in a really good area, so they'll be looking for a better delivery though.
Seven. And Thistle colours ready to attack. McLaughlin with an important header. Bullock accepts the throw. Long kick pointing. Howitt defending. Ewens turns and provides for McCleary. McCauley racing away. I think she was aware that she just strayed into an offside position as the ball didn't arrive when she wanted it to. And Ava Easton will collect. Brian Graham brought Ava Easton to the club, saying she's good enough to push Megan Cunningham for the starting position. He's on loan from Rangers and can't play against their parent side this afternoon. The same for Jenna Ferguson. Three changes for Rangers with Middach, Essen, the goalkeeper, and Sarah Ewens coming in. Three changes for Partick Thistle too, with Easton, the goalkeeper, coming in alongside Taylor and Longcake. McCauley chasing. Falconer forced into a decision.
Just like I said in the first half, Stuart, that I thought that Joe Pawthard would switch Jodie McCleary and Mia McCauley, and that's happened. Obviously feels that not getting enough joy down the wide areas. I think Rachel McLaughlin was Rangers' best player in the first half, so they're probably looking to get their wingers more involved in the game.
Headed through for McLean. Which way will she go? Clipped over, dangerous. Ewens looking to get the touch. It doesn't provide any threat to Easton. Sarah Ewens looking for her first Rangers goal.
That's a fantastic delivery. Somebody has to get on the end of that. It's an unbelievable cross. Just need to meet it, and it's probably going to be in the net. Somebody needs to throw themselves at it.
It's also the patient play from Kirsty McLean, having to wait to find that crossing position, and she found the angle on the edge of the box really well.
It's something she's so good at, is turning and twisting to get herself out of really tight areas, and then to get her first touch out of her feet to then get crosses and passes going. It's so hard to mark.
Here she is again, lifting it over for Howitt to chase. Lawton thought about it, took that second, puts out of play. McCleary with the throw for Rangers.
It was probably the right decision, actually, from Lawton not to go back to your goalkeeper there. Sometimes you're just better clearing your lines and allowing the rest of the team to get back in and set.
Doherty for Hardy. McLean's asking. Ewins takes over. Mia McCauley with all the space. Blocked by Faulkner. Slater clears. Victoria Essen, her first start of the season after starting in three World Cup group matches over the summer. McLean, McCauley, can't return the favour. Emmett chases Easden. You see Joe Potter sitting down in the technical area. Possibly going through some potential upcoming changes to inject further into this for Rangers, but it's Thistle who are threatening at the moment. Longcake had Hay coming up, but she couldn't keep possession. Hardy looks for Ewins. Partick Thistle continue to sweep those passes through up. Amy Bullock here. Slater battling with Ewins. McCauley trying to move away. The whistle blows. McCauley keeps on going, but the play will be brought back for the free kick. McLaughlin. That looks well weighted for McLean. Kept in. Four in the box. McCauley will cross towards Hardy, and then McCleary, and Thistle get it clear. A strong stop from Ava Easden in the second line of defence there to get it away. Rio Hardy just didn't know where the ball was. She couldn't get it out of her feet. Before the throw-in will be taken, the referee will check on the injured player, Longcake, but here's that play again. McCleary just trying to get the shot on target. She possibly should have picked either side rather than straight at the goalkeeper, Claire.
You're exactly right. It's anywhere else in the goal, it's probably as a goal. It's straight at the goalkeeper. But it's good play. It's good run from McLean into the corner. And then, just as you'd said earlier, but patience coming back to McCauley, I think it was, to whip the ball in. And Hardy just can't sort her feet out. But she does have the composure to find McCleary. And as you said, it's just the final shot, really. It's right at the goalkeeper. Partick Thistle do well to crowd the box and get it away.
Partick Thistle look to be readying a change. And it will be Megan Robb coming on. Made her mark early against Montrose last Sunday. Thought she had a double two until the assistants flagged and denied her on her first Partick Thistle start. It's Imogen Longcake who is receiving the attention. Important player, Thistle's attack too. Looks like she wanted to stay on, but directed off by the referee, Brian Graham, being cautious. He spoke about the depth that he spoke about in the squad now this season, so he feels a change can help his side too.
I think she's had a good game today. I think she's done well for Partick Thistle down that wide area. But yeah, it's probably is just precaution, taking her off, making sure that there's nothing too serious happening there. But Rob coming on, just said she managed to get her first goal for them. I think it'll just give them a different dynamic.
Joined in July from Driver Athletic in the Championship. Yeah. fifth appearance for Thistle this afternoon. Doherty for Howitt. Howitt for Hardy. Has found the space. Ewan's attacking. Claims both ways, and the referee awards the goal kick. That's more of what Rangers want to see from Sarah Ewan's in the box, making that run towards the front post.
It is. She's probably not done enough in this game, has she? But it's good to see Hardy starting to come in to the game. Really positive run into the box. Good ball back, but it's a really hard angle to score from there. She's almost past the front post, so it's really difficult to try and wrap your foot around it and get it towards the goal.
McGowan finds Henderson and keeps on running. Rebecca McGowan. Number 9 picks out Sinclair. The late challenge, the referee paused to think about it and has the yellow card out of the pocket again. And Partick Thistle will have a wonderful opportunity here to threaten from the free kick. Cara Henderson with the ball in her hands. There's the challenge again, it's Nicola Doherty who comes sliding in. And she's the next name in referee Jamie Wilkie's book.
She completely mistimes that challenge there and catches her. It's definitely a yellow card. I don't think she meant it. However, she's not close to the ball at all, so absolutely a free kick in such a good position here for Partick Thistle.
Hasson estimates the danger. Henderson looks in command over the ball for the free kick. Will it be a bit of Henderson magic? It won't be. Taylor with the strike. It's taken by Essen comfortably.
This was really quite disappointing in the end. She didn't really get any purchase behind it, and it's an easy one for Essen to take.
Lindsay Taylor made her comeback from injury, coming on as a sub against Montrose in the victory. Slater, pushed by McCauley. Thistle free kick. Slater had another solid game in the first half, continuing that in the second. Faulkner, that one long. We saw Brian Graham make the change with Longcake taking a knock and Rob coming on clear. Do you think it might be long until we see Joe Potter look to our bench? It's quite a young substitutes bench again for her this afternoon. Laura Berry's there, Mason Clark, Ailey Austin, Kayla Jardine.
It is a young bench, but again, you've seen how well the young talent in this squad have done, so I don't think she'll have any issue with bringing them on, but certainly I do think she'll be looking to make changes because I don't think that they're giving enough for her right now.
It's Thistle, who look like the team with the momentum. Emma Lawton there continues to get up and down from that right fullback position. So asking for a free kick, but play continues. Henderson nods on. He can't get there. Hardy with the flick. Howitt. Demi Faulkner. In between Robin Henderson. Hill's just happy to get it away. Brian Graham is getting louder and louder on that touchline. But may Rangers pounce here. Superb sliding challenge from Demi Faulkner. Appreciated by the crowd. Rob is away from McLaughlin. Rachel McLaughlin's done brilliantly there to get back and prevent the danger.
It's a great tackle by Faulkner, isn't it? She has to make it. She's had a good game in there for them, actually. And as you said, them breaking down with Rob. But Rachel McLaughlin equally has had a good game for Rangers.
It just feels like Rangers are the ones being pushed further back at the moment. Thistle having more of the ball.
They definitely are. They're picking up the ball in much more dangerous areas now compared to a large majority of the first half. I think they only managed to sustain that maybe for the first 10-15 minutes. So we have started really well. I still think, you know, they've had good opportunities from set pieces, which have been disappointing.
You want that to count, though. You want something to show for it. But there's still danger at the back. Emma Lawton looks after it. Gives possession to Ewins. Rangers throw. The game becoming more and more open now.
It's a really, really intelligent run by Sarah Ewins in there, and it's matched perfectly, isn't it, by Lawton. I think Partick Thistle have done so well defensively today to minimise Rangers getting third man runs and runs in behind and in between them.
Possession given away to Thistle. Joe Potter asks for the throw to be taken back. The Rangers support try to provide an injection of energy into their side. Thistle throw. Rob moves away. Can't find Slater.
And the longer this game goes on, it'll actually be Rangers that'll feel the nerves and feel the pressure already to win anyway. So I think that you'll see Partick Thistle getting more and more momentum if it stays 1-0.
Approaching the midway point of the second half. Rangers leading through Kirsty Howitt's first half goal with 20 minutes on the clock. Stays in play. Bullock's clearance. And then again. The last touch of the Thistle player. Docherty aware of McCleary in space. Lawton rushes out. Well worked by McCleary. Stopped by Bullock's challenge. Now Cody Hay has time to run. She's away from Tessel Mida. Henderson, did she strain to an offside position? Yes, says the assistant. And another one breaks down for Partick Thistle.
It's really good play by Hay there down the right wing. She slows the game down to try and allow her teammates to get up the pitch. Then gets a better Midag inside her. And it's a really good, intelligent ball through for Henderson, who just doesn't get a run right.
Thistle made that change earlier. Rob on for long kick. They also have McQuillan, Robinson, Munro, Wright, Adams and Docherty all on the bench. So it's a strong row of subs. Hardy, could be 4-on-4 for Rangers. Lindsay Taylor cuts it out. Standing strong again. Ewins, McCauley, it's in space on the right wing. Ewins turns the other way. Howitt, Peels, she's onside. Players arriving. Mia McCauley, one of them. Bullock, the other. To kick that one out of play, and Rangers will have a corner.
They have been so good as a back four though, Thistle, in terms of their positioning and what they're doing as a unit. They're not getting pulled apart and detached.
It's Rangers' first corner of the game. Midak's delivery over everyone. And Bullock hoping for the ball to cross the white paint, and it does for the Partick Thistle goal kick. 1-0 it stands. Rangers would have hoped from better from that set piece, and now Clare Adams will come on. Brian Graham looking to freshen things up in the midfield. It looks to be Lucy Sinclair who's going across towards the touchline. She had another good game in midfield, Clare.
She has done. I think she's probably not got on the ball as much as she would like, right enough. I don't think she's had the influence that she would probably like to have had in this game. But it's just a different type of player that they brought on. Adams, very good passing range, maybe not as direct as Sinclair, but certainly will pose a different problem for Rangers.
And Rangers making the changes too, with Kayla Jardine and Laura Berry coming onto the pitch.
I'm not surprised to see changes from Rangers. I think it was much needed. I think certainly up front today, Howitt, Hardy and Dunes, they're obviously very good players, but it's been pretty individual. They've not linked particularly well, so I think they're just looking for something else to freshen it up.
Easton with a goal kick. Kessel Medak. Adams with a first touch. Doherty. The goal scorer. Medak. Back for Hardy. Cleary has to turn away. Hill. Loughlin sidesteps Rob. Still swarmed around by that pink and grey. The Rangers pushed back. Lawton can't take it into her control. Hardy, Berry ahead. Another perfect sliding challenge from Taylor. Kessel Medak. Slater unaware of where the ball was dropping. Rob wins the throw for Partick Thistle.
The game's becoming quite frantic. The ball's turning over from Rangers to Partick Thistle and vice versa quite a lot, which both managers, I'm sure, will not be happy about.
Rob. Just over a quarter to play. Hardy heads on for Howitt. Rangers throw. Hardy. Looking for how it cleared away. Now worked by Kayla Jardine. Here she is again. McLaughlin. McLean was looking to continue the second run. Kirsty Howitt. McLean in space. Kirsty McLean takes. Now McCleary. Deep cross. Jardine can't get there.
I have been impressed with Partick Thistle today. I think the work that Brian Graham's done with them over the seasons, the last couple of seasons, I think you can see the progression. Even there, you know, they're really limiting Rangers to balls into the box that are creating nothing. So I think at least he has to be happy with that.
Ahead of the Glasgow City match earlier in the season, they wanted to take that form and competitiveness from last season into this one. I feel the disappointment after that 3-0 defeat. There won't be much disappointment around the performance, but there will be a disappointment if they want to take something from this game, you feel, Claire?
I think they probably will feel that way, because they have had, especially as I'd said, they keep going on about set pieces, and I think when they look back at the set pieces they've had, they'll be a bit frustrated with themselves that they've not actually made more of them. So, but largely, as you said, to do with the performance, I think they have performed well, particularly defensively.
Slater looking at the options for the throw. Adams is joining. She'll receive. Slater aims for the penalty box. But he can't work anything from that. Joe Potter watches on. McLean, it's heavy. Bullock smashes that one upfield. Essen kept two clean sheets against Partick Thistle in the league last season. As it stands, she's on course to keep one for this season. Rangers haven't kept one so far. Hey. Shot for Lawton. She'll take the throw. She wants some quick movement. Cody Hayes there now, but Henderson is close by in the penalty area. And the referee answers the Rangers' claims of handball in agreement and awards the free kick. Cara Henderson in disbelief.
It's just bounced off her and flipped up onto her hand. It's unfortunate actually, because she's gathered the ball in a good space in the box, but I think Joe Potter, what she'll be wanting is Rangers are just forcing everything that they've got is going forward. What they need to realise, or need somebody on the pitch to realise, is that they're actually winning the game, so they don't need to be so frantic going forward and just maybe keep the ball for a period of time and move Partick Thistle around.
Is this where that game management comes into play?
It is, and somebody on there or collectively need to try and do that and try and really calm the game down and just move the ball around. And it's all about game management, because as I did say, if it remained 1-0, Partick Thistle are going to start getting momentum coming into the last game, the 10 minutes of the game, and you'll just see that it will become quite nervy at the back, I think, for Rangers.
Hill in no hurry. McCleary. Middach. Claims of handball. Another free kick given. This could be dangerous. Rangers have the quality from these kind of situations. They want to seal a victory at home here at Broadwood. After 15 minutes to play, Evan Easton organises the defensive wall. Middack aiming for Hill, but he's there. Comfortably taken by Easton. That's an important save.
That isn't. It's a floating ball in and she gets her head on it. It's just probably not enough pace in the cross for it to generate any power in the header.
Rebecca McGowan. Docherty lets it bounce. The overhead clearance. Taylor aiming for Rob. Slater's touch is heavy. Partick Thistle will keep possession. Neck muscles used by Laura Berry there. Partick Thistle head coach retrieves the ball. Hardy. Good work. Berry slips. Hardy searches out Kirsty Howitt, who touches. And great defending. Somehow, Emma Lawton clearing on the goal line. She lost her feet, but she fell in the right place. And Kirsty Howitt couldn't add a second to her name this afternoon.
It was a great ball in. First time pass in by Hardy there to Howitt. And she can't get it down. And you think Lawton's done enough to clear the ball, and then it falls again to Kirsty Howitt, and somehow she's in the right place. Really, really good stop on line.
We thought Easton had it in her hands. But Emma Lawton, well aware. Superb defending, and it keeps the score at 1-0. But Rangers have the corner. Referee in conversation with the two number 18s. With instructions for Rachel McLaughlin before taking. Clipped up. Drops for Hill. Now McCleary. And pushed away onto the top of the net. Rangers have another corner. The home side pushing and pushing now.
And this is exactly what Partick Thistle don't want, is this period of pressure for them. They need to try and defensively stay strong, but what a header it is.
And for Hill with the header off the crossbar, and the whistle blown for the foul on Cara Henderson. And all of a sudden, this second half is sparked into attacking life.
Yeah, it's a great delivery. It's obviously a foul in the box. Catherine Hill rises highest and heads it off the crossbar, but Partick Thistle just need to regain their composure here and then look to try and get into the areas where they can hurt Rangers.
It was Demi Faulkner's header that took the ball over the crossbar earlier from McCleary's strike. She's had a few this afternoon, Jodie McCleary. Here she is on the ball. Control from Howitt. And he looks to run through. Demi Faulkner guarding. Away from Easton. Medak heads back. Doherty charging. Cara Henderson. Down again. That's actually Rebecca McGowan. Just thinking from the position here, it's Cara Henderson helping out. But it's just a sign clear of just how committed the Partick Thistle team has been this afternoon. And that performance that they've battled against Rangers today.
It is. She's done some amount of running in there, McGowan, so it looked like a little bit of cramp, which probably a lot of them could suffer with given the effort that they've put in today to this game.
The referee stopped play again. Kirsty Howitt walks away. And Lawton another. Let's have a look there. Cody Hay was trying to drag the ball away too.
Both just battling for the ball, and I think her arms swung and hit her in the face.
Emma Lawton returning to Thistle after playing for the club as a teenager. Won the SWFL Division 1 in 2018. Went to Manchester City. Now back after a spell at Motherwell. The referee blows the free kick, the late clip on Doherty. Still Kirsty Howitt, the only goal scorer in this one. Ryan Graham makes another decision to try and help his team find an equaliser, and it will be Rosie McQuillan coming on. Rebecca McGowan, who was just down earlier, as the player withdrawn.
It's maybe a little roll of the dice here, bringing on Rosie McQuillan, which is a more forward player. That might be coupled by the fact that McGowan's went down with a bit of cramp, but I think he's probably thinking this is the time to try and go for it.
McQuillan made a dream debut, scoring a Thistle second goal when they had 10 players in the 4-0 win against Dundee United. Medag's free kick helped on. Ava Easton again in command. She'll let the team move further upfield. Over 5 minutes left to play at Broadwood. Partick Thistle move up the pitch. Brian Graham asks his players to keep going.
That's where it's important that they need to try and keep the ball in those situations. You can't afford to give it away there. So you're looking for an equaliser in the last couple of minutes, and it's your throw-in, and then you're turning the ball over so easily. They need to try and do better in those circumstances so they can try and create something for themselves in the final third.
Taylor for Rob, lifts it towards Cara Henderson, just can't get there. Strong positioning from Docherty. Essen collects, and Rangers will look to go on the counter. Gershwin McLean won't get there.
That was much better though, good from Rob down and the ball in. It's a really difficult ball in to try and get it to Henderson, but she gives it everything, doesn't she? Throws herself at it to try and get anything on the end of it, but Nicola Docherty actually does defend well.
Lawton. Cleary there to take for Rangers. Faulkner cushions the header, but only to McLean. McQuillan can't draw the ball in. McLaughlin. Kayla Jardine. McLean. Rangers keep the ball. Joe Potter asks for it to go forward. Brian Graham wants his team to step up. Are we in for a tense final few minutes? Rangers still ahead. Kirsty Howitt, the goal scorer, after 20 minutes. That will be enough as it stands for Joe Potter to take the 3 points. Long from Easden. He heads on. Howitt gives Berry something to chase. Lindsay Taylor. Clearance took a deflection. McCleary takes. Chinking pass two. And the referee will drop back for the free kick.
Really, really good feat from her in here to skip away from those three players just getting clipped in the heels, and then obviously gets her side the free kick. But I definitely think Faulkner has had some game for Partick Thistle, just everything, her positional sense, her attacking of the ball. I think she really, really commanded the line well.
Medag will take towards Hill, who heads on, but it's tame and collected by the goalkeeper again. She wants to move quickly, and she gets the kick all wrong. It's still in play. Berry. McLean for Kayla Jardine. Pass two. Lovely exchange with McLean. Cleared away by Bullock. Thistle throw. To the final couple of minutes. Hardy, Berry, back to Rio Hardy. Another Cam, experienced in keeping possession. Docherty, New Slater had to attack that Rangers throw. Kirsty McLean wriggles away from Bullock, and a quite clear pull of the shirt from the Thistle midfielder means the yellow card comes out again, and Rangers, this is in their favour. Will they go for a second goal, or will they try and keep a hold of possession?
I don't think it was sensible there to give that foul away in that situation. I know she's got away from her, but you know, she's probably given them a better opportunity now with the free kick. And just to answer your question, I don't think that Rangers won't go for the second goal. I can't see them keeping possession here. I think they'll definitely put the ball in the box, but they definitely are not, I don't think, managing the game as well as they could be.
And that raises the left arm, clipped up towards Hill. Hardy there too. Jodie McCleary. Lawton sends it up in the air. Only one goal here so far this afternoon. There's been 21 across the other SWPL games in the top flight today. Plus a couple from yesterday. You can see all the highlights on Sports Scene tomorrow, 7 p.m. on BBC Scotland and BBC iPlayer. Well, we have another to add to that at Broadwood. Essen readjusts. Docherty loses control. McQuillan feeds it towards Rob, who takes it first time with the header, but the flag was raised down to her right also, so it wouldn't have mattered. And Essen happy to smother. We just think back, Clare, it wasn't Joe Potter in charge last season, but the game here against Hearts towards the end of the league campaign, Hearts got a penalty late on, equalised, and it just gives you that feel again of Rangers needing to manage the game with the one goal lead towards the end.
It does, and I've said a couple of times in commentary that I don't think that they've done it well enough. They don't need to score another goal. If it's 1-0 and they've the ball, then Partick Thistle can't score a goal. I think they've been frantic. I think that passage of play just proves it, but it's went back to Essen. She looks really nervy, kicking it out, Nick Dock under pressure. So Partick Thistle shouldn't be discouraged. I think they will get opportunities in the last couple of minutes here.
Four results when they met last season. 3-0 to Rangers, 5-0 to Rangers twice, and a 6-0. It's only one at the moment. Is it about to become two? McLean for Howitt. Jardine supporting. Hay clears away. Rio Hardy strikes. It doesn't catch it cleanly. Not as she would have liked. Two additional minutes played so far. Is there time left for Partick Thistle? Howitt looking for Berry. Easton stays composed. McLean's header. Megan Robb takes possession. Can't get past McLaughlin. Hardy for Berry. Faulkner stays strong, but so does Laura Berry. Thistle pressing. Bullock and Hardy, with the Rangers player coming out on top. That's a brilliant pass from Amy Bullock. Hill stays composed. Medak has given that away. Docherty for McCleary. Medak again, just needing to settle that.
You actually seen Kirsty Howitt throwing her hands in the air at frustration just with the lack of composure.
How long do Partick Thistle have left? Lawton launches. Mida clears away. Demi Faulkner only finds Hardy. She plays the easy pass. McLaughlin feeding. Berry won't give that up, but the ball has too much on it. And the referee, Jamie Wilkie, blows the full-time whistle. Rangers claim the 3 points, and Joe Botter's side respond to the draw against Glasgow City with a victory here at home. But they didn't have it all their own way, Rangers. It was a difficultly fought afternoon, and Kirsty Howitt scoring the only goal in the first half. Partick Thistle with a solid performance, but they will not take any points from this game. And you will feel that Brian Graham will have a sense of disappointment around that. Rangers didn't manage the game as cleanly as they possibly could have towards the closing stages, but that doesn't matter now as they go away with the 3 points and a victory this afternoon at home at Broadwood thanks to the goal from Kirsty Howitt. Final thoughts from Claire Gemmell.
I think, as you said, you know, Rangers probably haven't managed the game as well as they could, and I think Joe Potter in the whole probably won't be that happy with their performance, but at the end of the day it's the 3 points that matter. They've scored the goal, but from a Partick Thistle point of view, I think their performance was in fact very good, particularly defensively. It's just those other fine moments in the game in the final third where they're maybe not just creating enough against these top teams, but it's something that they look so much better at, and they will continue to improve, I'm sure.
Here is the goal, the pass through, Howitt striking. Easton might look at that one and feel she could have done better, as that was the goal that made the difference this afternoon. But still a strong start to the season from Partick Thistle. Without key players, as you see there, Cheryl McCulloch and Rachel Donaldson, the only points that they've dropped have been to sides that finished in the top three last season, and they keep getting closer and closer. For Rangers, their strong start continues. It means Joe Potter's side have picked up 13 points from a possible 15 as they keep on the pressure at the top of the Scottish Power Women's Premier League table. It finishes this afternoon at Broadwood. Rangers 1, Partick Thistle 0.